I get? Oh, darn. I got number 14. Okay.
But yes, we have time for your order, 100%. 3B. You got it. 3B. Look at you! She got her a free OG, y'all!
You got a free OG, Elaine!
Y'all, I'm not kidding when I say newbie luck is real. I'm really not kidding.
Elaine!
It is for real.
Elaine got a newbie, a free OG!
Elaine, would you like the same stuff?
Special dispensation. Tonight only, since it's just the members and this will never be out into the universe. If you want to order a fizz from her, be free. I won't. I mean, I know. They just seem like they're, I mean, they've obviously, they're not good enough at manipulating to, like, get people to sign up on their team, you know? I just feel bad. And the fact that she was honest about it and didn't lie and say, like, yeah, this is where people fill it out to sign up, you know?
Everybody.
I'll keep us safe. I shouldn't have done it. I feel like what I am going to do is I'm going to get it appraised. I'm going to record it to see if they're willing. I'm going to get the printout if they give an appraisal for it. And I'll go with my dad to make sure that I'm brave enough to ask the question. And then I'll make a video and warn other people. And I won't say where I got the ring. And I won't ever make this public because it's going to encourage other people to buy from her. So I feel bad. I'm sorry.
We're going to see what
you got. Like it's hot.
Here we go.
We're fizzing.
Last call, y'all. Anybody?
Cry. But the niceness. How hard she worked. How hard she worked on her background. Her costumes. Her boiling pot with the eyeballs.
Hello and welcome back, or welcome for the first time to the Bree Bear Show. Yes, today I am holding my mic in an effort to not be like this with the camera. We gather here today because there is a copious amount of commotion in the anti-MLM space right now. Before I visit that, however, I would like to provide a bit of background. MLM stands for multi-level marketing. Think Avon, Amway, Prove It, Herbalife, Arbonne. These are all multi-level marketing companies. And anti-MLM is the movement of advocates who speak up against this industry of MLM or network marketing, social selling, social retail. There's all kinds of words for it that are used interchangeably, speaking against it because of the manipulative tactics that are used in it and because a lot of people don't make money, lose money, puts them in a bad financial spot. So in the last few years, I would say since about 2020, there was a mass YouTube creator surge. Mostly women entering the anti-MLM space after leaving multi-level marketing companies. Now, you don't have to be someone who was in an MLM to call yourself anti-MLM or to be a creator in the anti-MLM space. There is a lot of subtlety and conjugation in this space. It is layered, it is multifaceted, and while it has been labeled a movement, it truly isn't that for some. For some, it is simply a path to monetize their clicks and their views, a way to trend and make easy money while demonizing something they are or maybe aren't really familiar with. There are some great content creators in this space who do have a lot to do with the advocacy and activism of the movement. One of them even infiltrates scammy companies and exposes the behind-the-scenes workings of these companies to better inform the public. Some of them go through the content of problematic MLM coaches and reveal the manipulative tactics that are very cult-like that are used in the content to try and gain more paying members. There are people who produce podcasts and interview former members of MLMs. There are people who are advocates and have been featured in documentaries like Lula Rich. And then there are some who are more active on blogs and on social media, like Instagram, for example, posting carousels and stories, updating their audiences on the different situations that are current, that are unfolding in the MLM and anti-MLM space alike. A lot of this content is highly educational, and at the same time, they are advocating for people like me, people who were at one time a victim of multi-level marketing. But then, like I said, there are people that I call anti-MLM Avengers. These are the ones who left MLM, multi-level marketing, and went into content creation like swiftly off the jump without any time to truly focus on themselves, to focus on their healing. And within this Avenger space, there is a copious amount of therapy talk, echo chambers, groupthink, and a lot of culty tactics. Now remember what I said they're fighting against. It's incredibly ironic. According to Stephen Hassan's BITE model from freedomofmind.com, and there's a resource, there are four elements of manipulative control that are evident in cults. These are behavior control, and this category explores how manipulative groups regulate and dominate their members' actions and behaviors through strict rules, rewards, and punishments, limiting individual autonomy. It instills dependency and obedience, and if a member doesn't comply or conform, they're often disenfranchised or excommunicated. Number two is information control, examining the tactics of manipulative organizations to control the information flow through censorship and propaganda, restricting members' access to outside perspectives. This includes things like deliberately withholding information, distorting information, things like lying, or creating an insider versus outsider doctrine, like a you can't sit with us environment. Number three is thought control. This focuses on psychological techniques used by such groups to shape beliefs and attitudes, suppressing critical thinking and promoting conformity. Things like the use of loaded language and cliches that constrict knowledge, using platitudinous buzzwords to reduce complexities or cause a lack of thought. Also, a rejection of constructive criticism or forbidding critical questions about leadership or doctrine, labeling alternative belief systems as evil or illegitimate. Lastly, emotional control or emotion control, which explores how manipulative organizations manipulate emotions, fostering dependency and loyalty through things like love bombing, guilt, and fear-based indoctrination, and quick extreme highs or lows from one end of the emotional spectrum to the other. One moment you're loved and being love bombed, and the next moment you're being persecuted. So I mentioned the BITE model and the different qualifiers of it because there's been so much of it used in the MLM space, but also there's been a lot of it used in these different sects of the anti-MLM space, particularly the anti-MLM Avenger space. And I do call it that to kind of create a sect, not to generalize anti-MLM as a whole. And that alone is baffling. The very fact that they are creating the environment they have been actively condemning for so long is weird. It's ironic. I was in an MLM myself, and I do know firsthand that indoctrination happens regardless of what anyone in MLMs tell you. And I know for sure I was in a high control group, and there was a great deal of indoctrination that happened that I needed to deprogram. The whole premise of the anti-MLM creator movement is that they are trying to stop people from joining MLMs or encourage them to get out. However, I speculate that many of them have not deprogrammed at all and are furthering the harm that was caused to them by perpetuating it. At first, I felt very much alone in this sentiment. I released my very first YouTube video on this channel in February of this year without the intent of going into any form of anti-MLM content with YouTube. And I've garnered way more support than I originally anticipated. Since then, a lot has happened. Some creators have left social media altogether just because I highlighted or featured them in one video. A whole subreddit has been created to give people like me a space to vent ethically and without severe personal attacks. Some creators have gotten worse, particularly the one we will be highlighting today. Some creators have simply blocked me or tried to deplatform me or tried to attack me in an effort to make me look less credible, to discredit me. And in my opinion, that is simply an effort to control information. But one thing that none of them have done is held themselves accountable for the contribution of harm that they personally have created in this space. So now let's get started on today's topic. The intro clips that you watched before my lovely face came on the screen was an anti-MLM creator who has been in the space for a little over a year, I believe. She'll highlight her background, I think, in the video that we're about to watch. I only cut out parts of the video where there is no content, meaning she's either sobbing or having technical difficulties or actively pausing and not saying anything. So I'm not removing any context. And I say this because she is often trying to pass off her indiscretions by gaslighting her audience and saying, "I was clipped out of context," and you will see what I mean. It is technically supposed to be an apology, but in all honesty, she should have just brought a ukulele. I want to also thank the woman who I got these clips from and who made us all aware of this happening. That is the MLM police. And by the way, I did speed this up a little bit. I will come in and out to leave my commentary, and this first stretch is a little long, but I will be back, I swear.
Good evening. It is Wednesday, October 4th at 6:05 p.m. Central, and this will be available for the replay for everybody. Here's what we're going to be talking about. A members only live that happened on Monday has gotten out to the rest of the internet, and I'm going to be able to give you some context if you're not a member and haven't seen it yet, and give you my perspective and have a short period of time that you can ask questions and I can answer them for you. I'm an MLM dropout. I was in Mary Kay Cosmetics in 2014 until 2015 or 16, I think 2016. And then I was in Young Living from 2019 until 2022 in April. And when I got out last year, I started making content, and I've been making content on unethical business practices and unethical recruiting practices since last year. And I have members tiers, so we do some members only streams. And we did a members only stream on Monday. We had a members only stream doing a bomb party rep on Monday, and she is one of the nicer people that we found. She has a husband who helps her sell her jewelry, and her kids also help her on her stream. And because I haven't blurred her face and I didn't want to sick people on her in terms of touching the poop, the nicer MLM person, we kept members only. And there have been clips from that members only stream going around. There's been frustration. I've seen it. I saw it in the members only stream where people were upset about what happened. And I'll tell you exactly what happened. There were conversations that happened in that members only stream. And now there's conversations happening on Reddit. And there's also conversations happening because there's other creators showing clips of me in their stories. And out of respect for the people who have decided to subscribe to my channel and become members on my channel, I want to give you the full context and be able to let y'all answer, ask some questions, and I can answer them. So on Monday, we were reacting to a bomb party rep, and she was dressed as Dr. Seuss, and her husband was dressed as Thing 2. And we had already done a live stream about her the day before. She was dressed as a scarecrow. She seemed really nice in the first stream. She seemed really nice in the second stream. And we were collectively sad that she didn't win the trip that Reveal Lady had gotten to go on. and she was still selling products, dressing up for Halloween. And it was an interesting it was an interesting kind of like peek through to see a rep who wasn't screaming, who wasn't who didn't really fit the mold of somebody who was angry or easily dislikable. It was easy to see why people would want to join her team. It was easy to see maybe why people like her. And so for the second stream, after we had already streamed about her on Sunday, we did another members only stream. I'm sorry. On Sunday, we did another members only stream on Monday. And the multi-level marketing company she's in is called Bomb Party, BP. And so the allure that I had was finding people in multi-level marketing who are nice, who it is easy for us who are not in MLMs anymore to connect with people. I'm out of respect for y'all. I'm trying to take a pause and all right. But the niceness, how hard she worked. How hard she worked on her background, her costumes, her boiling pot with the eyeballs. And so it was a lot of me being emotional and also rooting for this person. So by the time the second stream came around on Monday, I was like at the very beginning of the stream or near the beginning of the stream, I ended up ordering a ring from her for $19.95 plus tax. And personally, I hope that that doesn't take away the things I've tried to do on my channel to help people who are stuck in multi-level marketing, or I hope it doesn't take away from the help I've tried to give to other creators. And I hope it doesn't take away from the content I've tried to share with other people.
She is mentioned in the subreddit quite a bit. People saying, like, I actually stopped watching her because I couldn't stand her crying. And me personally, I'm not against a public display of emotion. I've cried on my own YouTube videos. But what I am against is emotional manipulation or emotional control. This appears to be emotional manipulation to me. Now, I'm not a cult expert or anything, but in my opinion, she has cultivated a space where she's coddled by her audience because she is so intensely up and down emotionally. She's created this safe space where everyone... My light is going crazy. Where everyone has to tiptoe around her feelings. Now, she's a grown woman. She's my age. And this is the real world. No one has to tiptoe around anyone's feelings necessarily. Especially not on the internet. The way I look at it, if you can't take the heat, baby, get out of the kitchen.
I did not initially buy it to test it or to see its authenticity. I wanted to support her because she seemed like she was working really hard and I was making content off of her. And then the members spoke up very strongly about their disappointment in me buying something live while I was streaming. And I want to make that clear that I have not created an echo chamber with members, although we have booted some people.
She said, I have not created an echo chamber with my members, although we have booted some people. She told on herself right there, probably unintentionally in an effort to be honest, but it is truly telling.
That I'm open to conversations and dissenting opinions about my behavior. I was never going to make that stream public because I understand the influence that someone can have, like me, and encourage people to buy from multi-level marketing companies.
Could we consider this information control? Keeping her stream as members only, or at least initially intending to do so, she was cultivating a space for herself and her members to act in a way that they wouldn't act in a public setting or on a regular live stream on her channel.
And it hasn't been taken down. It was members only from the beginning. The person who got the clips got them from a member. It was never a situation where I was going to hide that stream. It was always going to be available for the members. And I don't clip people out of context on purpose. And I'm emotional about getting clipped out of context again.
This seems to me like it was meant to be kept a big secret. The person who got the clips got them from a member and basically passes the blame off to the person who clipped her out of context. But you can't clip facts out of context. It's almost like she is trying to deny that she did this or somehow lessen the blow because we, the public peasants who are not members, we're not supposed to see it or we haven't watched the whole stream.
I think that I regret buying it because I know that I know that it encouraged other people to buy it. We still had fun on the stream. And at the end of the day, even if she was faking, it's $19.95.
So remember right here how lax she is. She acts like it shouldn't matter since it was such a seemingly small, insignificant purchase. Just remember that for later.
I'm not looking to do that again in the future. I'm trying to be honest. I don't necessarily feel in the I'm sorry realm.
See what I mean? Non-apology. This is not an apology. It is, if nothing else, an admission of guilt. And, you know, I'll give her that, but not without her trying to make us feel bad for her.
I mostly feel nervous because
I got caught.
There were a lot of questions. There's a lot of frustration about that members only video, and I want to be able to answer y'all's questions. So I think that it's a situation where I can again see why someone love bombing or someone being nice or someone creating an atmosphere where it seems fun to buy can pull people into multi-level marketing companies and get them to buy. Do I think morality-wise, does a $19.95 purchase, like, is that a moral thing? For me, it's not.
She mentions morals there, but not once in this video do I recall her mentioning ethics. And I find that interesting since she's always talking about people in MLMs being unethical and using unethical manipulation tactics.
I understand that this statement and the members only stream, those in combination make you feel like you want to not support my channel anymore. You have to do what's best for you. I have to navigate this the best I can as an individual, independent creator who has been trying to speak up about multi-level marketing companies. I think that the situation where we talk about being guilted into helping your friends because they're your friends and you want to support them and they're trying to make ranks in companies, I understand how getting into that ditch can prop up a broken business model like we see in all multi-level marketing companies. You know, and I think even more so being cautious around really kind people who are in multi-level marketing who seem genuine and nice can maybe be more alluring than some of the mean people that we've covered on my channel.
That's incredibly subjective, but okay.
Yeah, and I'm going to get it tested, but I want to be honest that that's not initially why I bought it. It was something that I'm happy to do after I bought it, and I recognize the frustration with members and with subscribers that I bought it. And I'm also saying that I personally don't think that, in my opinion, a $19.95 ring, a $19.95 ring is going to be the end of my channel. I mean, I'm still going to make content even if no one's here. I know that other creators who I have friendships with reached out to me and talked about the disappointment in me doing that.
Three wins. We're going to get to know about the pet MLM. Yes, it is a pet MLM. Yes, we are. I almost joined it. That is why
we can have conversations about differences of opinions and the respect and the friendship that's already there. We get to have those conversations, and I'm happy that people feel safe enough that they can speak up. And I think that's a good thing.
Interesting, because I remember Wormgate and all the speaking up people in anti-MLM did about Jessica. And just in case you missed it, another anti-MLM creator named Jessica made a TikTok about a deworming product for humans. And the anti-MLM community was up in arms about it because it is considered pseudoscience and could be very harmful to people. But it's kind of strange that I haven't seen a single member of this anti-MLM community say anything at all about this. And it has been weeks.
So the main points are, I had a members-only stream on Monday covering a rep that we had covered on a members-only the day before, the reps and bomb party. That's the day two on Monday of watching her stream. I purchased a $19.95 ring, and we had an ongoing long discussion in the live chat about the badness of that purchase. And I heard the members loud and clear. And then I also, afterwards, after buying the ring, I'm going to get it appraised. And I think it's going to be good. And I still don't encourage people to buy multi-level marketing products. Thanks, MK. And so if you have questions, and I think this one is a good question or a good statement to start with. We can make mistakes and learn from them. It's not the buying of the ring, but it's the perceived intention of support of MLMs as a whole. And I think that's a fair point.
Anyone else feel like her tone is intensely condescending?
In the process of making videos on my channel, talking about unethical business practices and unethical recruiting practices, I may at a later date be able to say, I feel strongly one way or other about the purchase. I understand there's lots of thoughts and frustrations about what I did. I'm not hiding what I did. It was for members only. I tried to create a stopgap for the influence to convince other people to buy from this bomb party rep.
All the excuses.
I'm always putting it in members only, and I was never going to put it live. And I don't know, like, maybe I'm not self-aware enough or evolved enough to say it was a mistake. I'm happy to, like, readdress it in the future. I wanted to be able to talk to the people who still like my content and be able to answer y'all's questions if you have it.
Okay, so not apologizing and simply patronizing her public peasant audience. Got it.
Thank you for the super chat.
Do you see people paying her through these super chats? So there is some speculation about why she streams so often and why a lot of them in the Avenger crew stream so often. She goes live on YouTube like every single day and sometimes more than once a day. Yeah. And her streams are hours long. Like sometimes 4 hours long. Personally, I think a part of it is so that people don't cover her. Anyway, did you see how her members or fans send her money? Well, in my opinion, they do it because they feel bad for her. Remember I said she's cultivated a space where people cater to her every emotion and all the lability in it? Often crying on streams when she doesn't get her way or when someone says something offensive or something that she just simply doesn't agree with, she sobs. She's emotionally manipulating throughout this whole stream. So far, she's been given about $15 or $20 through these chats. While she sits there and excuses her own behavior, doesn't apologize, and basically claims she is too weak to be held to a higher standard.
Thanks for the super chat. I appreciate it. So I'd love to ask, like, answer your questions. I was honestly yelling at my screen no when you were purchasing it, but again, 1000% get the moment of weakness, for lack of a better word. I have done something similar before. I appreciate you saying that. I think one of the things that hit hard in a bad way was someone, I don't know if it was on Reddit or in stories somewhere, where they were comparing what I did to an alcoholic taking a drink, and that gutted me because of my family's history with alcoholism.
Alcoholism is awful. Trust me, I know. However, it is quite interesting because in many videos in the past, she has said that MLM reps emotionally manipulate their audience members by sharing their stories, like, or their adversities, by being vulnerably and sharing emotionally touching things that they're trying to make their audience feel bad for them and in turn create an emotional connection. Well, isn't that what is happening right here? Just like when I pointed out that she isn't a mother, which is a fact, and facts are not attacks, according to the Avengers. And then she did a whole live stream about infertility, which also sucks. But she bawled through the whole thing and, in my opinion, emotionally manipulated people to feel bad for her and in turn see me as the villain. If that's the case, JL could have got on a lot of live streams and bawled about how these women were consistently tearing her and her relationships apart, or how they attacked her for every single little thing that she did. She couldn't do anything right. They have no idea how their words affected JL, and they didn't care. But if someone hurts you, you go live and literally cry about it to make them look bad in the eyes of your viewers. There's a lot of elements in the bite model coming into play with this, in my opinion. It's straight manipulation, deflection at its finest, and it's done to further the emotional connection and control that she has over her members or her fans, so that they'll act a certain way in cases of abhorrent behavior, like the one that we're highlighting right now.
And I don't want those kind of metaphors or comparisons used with me just purchasing one ring.
Minimizing the ring purchase like a mofo here. Just $19. It was just one ring. But it's the principle that matters, not what you spent.
I'm sorry I'm crying. I was trying to, like, not cry. I think we can learn from this. I think I certainly can learn from this. I was learning Monday from this situation because of the member conversation that we had in the live chat. And that's not something that has been shared with the frustrations and the clips that have been shown on the internet. I think there's people that are streaming tonight. I don't want to cut into their stream time.
This is oddly reminiscent of multi-level marketing. We were always told never stream when your upline or a teammate is live. We would get berated for taking the attention away from our uplines or anyone in direct connection with us.
Do y'all have any I appreciate the members that were on the live stream where we got to have real-time conversations and experiencing everything and being able to talk through it. I learned a lot then. I'm happy to talk about it now live. I woke up late today, then went to PT, and then my mods told me what was happening. And then I wanted to be able to, out of respect for people who still support my channel, be able to answer your questions.
She really thought her members were loyal and wouldn't share this video. Like, very oddly reminiscent of MLMs once again.
Oh no, did someone give memberships? I'm like not seeing anything right now. I'm like just weeping and let's see. Restore chat. Top chat. Live chat. Oh no. Here we go. Brittany, member for 3 months. Appreciate you still being here. Just to lighten the mood, I want you to know your bun is fire today. Thanks so much.
I don't know exactly how gifting works, but I heard it's probably how people get into this membership area when they don't actually want to be there.
I'm happy to have conversations. Bloodbath Body Works, that's funny. Yeah, the ring that was revealed was ugly as hell, which is good. We were doing Lego reveals on the stream too to add some fun dopamine hits. And thanks, Sky. You're the best. Danny Carr gifted 5 DC memberships. Holy crap. Okay, let me see if I can. I don't even know if I can play sounds. I personally don't think that this is a black and white situation where it's a morality thing. I still can reflect as I did on Monday. I'm happy to reflect further. I would love if you have a problem with me to ask me the questions. But if you can't, I understand that too. I understand I'm a public figure. I understand if you can get the information, you know, you're going to share it. I'm disappointed that the entirety of the conversation that happened in the members only on Monday isn't taken into consideration, and the range of the emotions and the discussion that was had.
Okay, but let's look at the facts and stop trying to dilute the situation with the delusion of being clipped out of context. The fact is, she bought a ring from an MLM. After saying multiple times that even purchasing a product from an MLM is considered supporting the reps or the companies, really the entity at large, and it's wrong.
Thanks, Mojo. Oh, great. I'm going to go look at those right now. What I'm going to speak on it right now. And if you have questions that you want answered, you can leave them in the comments and I will get to them as I have time. And thank you, Av. I appreciate you. Thank you. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to redirect to Aaron, and I appreciate y'all being here. If you have questions, leave them under this video and I will answer them as I have time.
Collectively, at least $25 to $30 was gifted through the super chats in this live. That's just what I saw myself. There could have been a lot more. And I do know that YouTube takes a percentage. That's probably means she cleared like $20 for a half hour stream. One of her shortest ever. I would say that's a pretty good hourly rate for crying and shifting blame. Nothing but a cash grab, in my opinion. She knew people would feel bad for her, and she ate it up. Let's not forget, the whole premise of the argument against MLMs is the emotional manipulation that is often used to entice people to join. And when people join, they give whoever they join money, basically. Not only is she mirroring that behavior, but she's participating in becoming a victim of it. so confusing. Okay, the next clips are clips. Like, I'm not going through an entire video because the duration of this was like 2 hours. I wish I had that kind of time to sit online and spew nonsensical things, but I don't. And I don't think that any of you want to go through all of that to get the major point either.
Oh my God. It's freaking awful. Weight-wise, I would be unhappy if I purchased a ring. What's the MSRP for this? The MSRP, $138. Stop it. It's not the worst one we've seen, for sure. It's not the best. And how flat the profile is. These are cloudy on the side. I may have to clean it with my jewelry cleaner. Here. There's little cubic zirconium on the side, and they're cloudy. So it's not heavy. This is rhodium plated. Sapphire, okay, dark pink sapphire fused with genuine quartz. Fused? What does that mean? Materials, rhodium plating. Oh my God. I'm just gonna turn my finger green. Yup, sure is. Oh my God, it's freaking awful. I wouldn't pay 138 pesos, you know? Like, I just don't even know what to say. The roundness of the sides, like, look how bad. Maybe we can zoom in. Please hold. Let me turn off the automatic focus. It's obviously dirty because I just touched it. But do y'all mind if I go clean it?
Look at this, Katie.
So the bomb party rep absolutely, in my opinion, has the right to copyright strike this video. She left and is streaming the live of the bomb party rep through her stream. There has not been any useful, valuable, constructive commentary relating to the stream that she is streaming through her stream. Talk about meta. For 2+ hours, which... you need valuable content to constitute fair use. You need commentary, and there's barely any. And when she is talking, she's doing her nails and then actively dogging on the ring that she purchased on a different bomb party rep's stream. And yes, YouTubers do this all of the time, but it doesn't make it right. Once again, it boils down to principle here. Someone screaming into the void all the time about ethics being blatantly unethical in our faces.
It's so bad. Look how awful it is. Oh my God, it's the most opaque piece of... So I cleaned it. It looks the same.
Seven. You are one autumn away from a clock.
To be fair... the clarity improved some. You still cannot see behind the stone. You obviously can see more of the... it removed any dirt. There's some... sparkle to it. Oh, I can't return it. It's a final sale. Am I going to post about it on Twitter? Yes.
Hey, thanks for following.
I don't think any jeweler in their right mind would put this value above $5.99.
Thank you. Okay, let's
see. See, like, the difference, like, my ring, when I clean it, it doesn't hold, like, smudges and stuff. Like, I don't... It's super clear.
Thank you.
Here's the name of the video. A beautiful dream into a horrible nightmare. Bomb party ring gets appraised. That's what I'm going to name it.
See how her energy changed? Just a few days later, after she has received the infamous ring, making this reveal, joking and making fun of the ring, when she is the one who chose to purchase it.
Do y'all like the floating candles?
Is this Tennessee Ernie Ford, I think?
Yes. You did call it. Yep.
I gotta sneeze.
Oh my god.
Excuse me. Excuse me again. So sorry.
Yeah. Yep. And it feels like really twisty for people to, you know, use. $19 and 95 cents is not something to sniff at either.
Wait.
Do I think morality wise, does a $19.95 purchase, is that a moral thing? For me, it's not. In my opinion, a $19.95 ring, a $19.95 ring. It's going to be the end of my channel.
The inconsistency? I cannot.
Like, it doesn't look good. The profile's so low. It's just... That's fine. The profile doesn't have to be large. I have my wedding ring that's a Tiffany flower ring, and the profile's low. And it is... very pretty, in my opinion. And then I had a custom guard for it. And I'm not saying low profile can't be pretty. I'm saying that, like, there's just a vast difference in craftsmanship.
Obviously, we're comparing apples to oranges here. And is she seriously humble bragging about having a Tiffany's ring?
Yep. I'm going to put it out publicly, and I'll put the appraisal with the picture of the ring in the Google Drive. So if y'all want to use it, if you're an anti-MLM creator, you can take it and use it too. I don't care.
Aw, look at her doing favors for the cause. Now, tell me, why would anyone want to use that? How would they give the background on that? Maybe like this. Hello, welcome to my video. So another anti-MLM creator bought this ring here in a moment of alleged weakness and then gaslit the internet because the video of her buying it was leaked. So then she felt bad, but not bad enough to apologize for it because apparently it's not a moral issue. And, you know, out of the kindness of her empathic little heart, she went and got it appraised. And let us losers use the appraisal for our own content because obviously we need her to boost us in the algorithm so graciously.
Not anymore. Oh, I forgot the charger.
So my dad and I are going to go get it appraised. And no, as a reminder, that was not my intent. I had a weak moment last week on Monday with a different bomb party rep, and I bought the ring. And it was a members only stream, and we kept it members only because... I was like, I didn't want to convince someone else to spend their money on it.
Really?
Look at you. She got her a free OG, y'all.
You got a free OG ring.
Y'all, I'm not kidding when I say newbie luck is real. I'm really not.
Natural dispensation tonight only since it's just the members and this will never be out into the universe. If you want to order a fizz from her. Be free.
Hmm.
And then that's what the video that was public was last week. And so this is the result of that. And after I bought it, I'm going to appraise it. So.
Okay, so tell me what y'all think about this situation. Even though the creator we highlighted here presented this as an innocuous occurrence, it was just a simple moment of frailty clipped out of context, do you think that's what it was? Because the energy she gave us in that last video says otherwise. I personally believe that we just watched a whole bunch of bite model tactics. I think there is a lot of manipulation happening within this anti-MLM Avenger movement, and that we all should be really cautious of who we trust and believe and create parasocial bonds with on the internet. Leave a like and make sure you subscribe so that you are notified of the next video. Thank you for coming to the Brie Bear Show. Goodbye.